हेलो एवरीवन, आई एम आरती नाइक. वेलकम वेलकम यू टू इरा ट्यूटोरियल. टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न इंग्लिश क्लास 8 सब्जेक्ट इंग्लिश यूनिट 1 1.2 डिक विटिंगटन एंड हिज कैट. दिस इज़ वेरी वंडरफुल स्टोरी. सो लेट अस सी बिफोर स्टोरी लेट अस सी वार्मिंग अप एक्टिविटी. क्वेश्चन नंबर 1. डिस्कस द फॉलोइंग इन ग्रुप एंड राइट द आंसर्स. Now you have to some famous personalities are given here. You have to identify name of these people. So first one everybody knows, Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam. Second, Abraham Lincoln. Third, Charlie Chaplin. And fourth, Kalpana Chawla. Guess the type of hardship they must have faced in their childhood and youth. So here are come some common hardship faced by all these. First is lack of support, lack of opportunity, social disapproval and poverty. Generally these are the hardship faced by many of the famous people. Next question. What strong qualities possessed by them could have helped them achieve success and fame all over? So their strong willpower, optimism, hard work and sincerity. Next question. How do stories or biographies of such famous people help youngsters? They inspire the youth. They help everyone to look at life positively. They help them to find answer to their questions. They prove that with our will, we can do anything. Now question number 2. Syllable. What is syllable? Syllable is a unit of pronunciation that has one vowel sound and may or may not have consonant sound before or after it. So generally we are in practice of it. Whenever we are speaking, wherever we are giving stress mark, we identify it. One syllable words are here: a, I, see, at, on, man, with, thread. Next, two syllables words: mother, seated, giraffe, parrot, active, happy. Now some three syllables words are here: happiness, wonderful, animal, surprising, adventure, ignorance. More than three syllables, consequently encouragement, responsibility, identifying, encyclopedia. Okay. Now, what you have to do with this activity, write the name of any five of your classmates and list how many syllables each name has. Okay, so you are writing, for example, Om, one syllable. Okay, like that you have to make the list of your friends and find out in his name or her name how many syllables are there. Now, let us see the story. Dick Whittington and his cat. There was once a poor boy called Dick Whittington who lived in a small village in the south of England. He had no proper home, for both his parents had died and he was unkindly treated by many of the villagers. One day, Dick overheard someone say that streets of London were paved with gold, and he decided that he would go there at once and pick his fortune up in gold pieces from the street, for he thought people might treat him more kindly if he were rich. Now, as he was not treated by the people, as he was not having both of his parents, he was alone, without any shelter, without any money, food, nothing he was having, and that's why people in his village were not treating him nicely. So he thought that in future if he will be rich, everybody will respect him. And he overheard from some people that streets of London were paved with gold. So he decided that let us go to London and let us find out some gold, and so that he can be a rich person. So young Dick set out to walk to London. He had not gone far when a man in a cart stopped and asked him if he was running away from home. That means when he was on the way to the London, One man with his cart, who was on the same way, he asked him, "Are you running away from the home?" Then Dick replied, "I have no home." Dick answered, "I am on my way to London to find my fortune." He said, "I don't have home. I have no one. So that's why I am going to London to find out my fortune." "I am going to London myself," said the carter. "Jump up here beside me and we will journey together." So Carter thought that he will get one company till London. They arrived in London just before nightfall, and the carter left Dick and made his way to an inn. To an inn means he went to the place where he can get food and shelter. Poor Dick stood alone and looked around him in dismay. That means great disappointment that man was having some place where he can take rest, he can eat food, but Dick does not have anything. He don't have any place to take rest, and he don't have food also. Where was all the fine gold? Now he is observing the streets of London. As people said that it is paved with gold, but here no gold is found. So where was all that fine gold? All he could see were dirty streets and lots of unfriendly people. He had nowhere to sleep, and in the end he spent the night in the corner of an alley where he hoped he would come to no harm. Finally he thought that at least he must take rest for night somewhere. So he decided to spend his night in a corner of an alley. Alley means a narrow passage between or behind buildings. So in that small place he decided to take rest. The next morning Dick woke up cold, miserable and very hungry. He wandered around begging for food, but again and again people shouted at him, "Go away, you lazy fellow, be off with you," and aimed angry blows at his head. That means all people, whoever he came in contact, they started shouting at him. At last, he collapsed in the street and lay there, too weak to look further for food. So as he was very small boy, and from long time he had nothing to eat, so because of weakness he collapsed in the street and lay there only because he was not having any strength to get up and go somewhere. By chance Dick had fallen in front of a house belonging to a rich merchant called Mr. Fitzwarren. The cook was trying to drive Dick away when Mr. Fitzwarren returned home from inspecting his ships. He stopped and said to Dick, "Why don't you work if you need food?" He asked Dick that if you want food, you have to work. No one will give you food in free. "I would work," said Dick, "but I know nobody who will give me anything to do." So Dick asked him that who will give him work. "Take him to the kitchen," Mr. Fitzwarren ordered the cook. "Feed him first and then find some work for him." So Dick was given a home and a living. He had a small corner of the attic to sleep in, and his job was to help the cook with all the pots and pans in the kitchen. Okay, so finally he got one home where he can live safely. He can have some food, and attic means a very small room inside a pointed roof. So he got one place where he can sleep, and he has to help the cook in cleaning pots and pans. Dick's life should have been much better than before, but he still had two difficulties to face. So now if we are thinking that early Dick was in many problems, एंड नाउ हिज लाइफ इज सेटल्ड. नो, नाउ हिज लाइफ इज नॉट सेटल्ड. अगेन ही हैज डिफिकल्टीज इन हिज लाइफ. सो टू डिफिकल्टीज आर हियर. लेट अस सी वन बाय वन. द फर्स्ट वॉज दैट द एटिक ही स्लेप्ट इन वॉज ओवररन बाय रैट्स एंड माइसिस. नाउ द प्लेस विच वॉज गिवन टू हिम फॉर स्लीपिंग देयर मेनी नंबर्स ऑफ रैट्स एंड माइसिस वर देयर विच डू नॉट अलाउ हिम टू टेक प्रॉपर रेस्ट. एट नाइट दे स्क्रैम्पर्ड ऑल ओवर हिम एंड केप्ट हिम अवेक. आफ्टर अ टाइम ही सॉल्व दिस प्रॉब्लम बाय सेविंग द फ्यू पेनीज ही वॉज पेड एंड बाइंग हिमसेल्फ अ कैट. इन नो टाइम एट ऑल द कैट चेज्ड अवे ऑल द रैट्स एंड माइस एंड डिक वॉज एबल टू स्लीप पीसफुली. सो नाउ हिज फर्स्ट प्रॉब्लम इज सॉल्व. नाउ लेट अस सी सेकेंड प्रॉब्लम. द अदर डिफिकल्टी विच वॉज नॉट सो ईजी टू ओवरकम. टू ओवरकम मीन्स सक्सीड इन डीलिंग विट और टू सॉल्व द प्रॉब्लम. इट वॉज नॉट ईजी. And what was that? It was the cook's bad temper. She shouted and screamed all day and would scold Dick and hit him with a wooden spoon even when he was working as hard as he could. As he was small, he was having some limitation to do some types of work. When he was unable to do any type of work, at that time cook, she used to scold him. And hit him with a wooden spoon. Even when Dick is trying to do hard work, at that time also she was not appreciating his work. That was the second difficulty of Dick. One night Dick decided he could stand it no more. That means one night he decided now it is difficult to tolerate with that cook. Early the next morning, before the cook was up, he set out with his cat to seek his fortune elsewhere. The two of them walked as far as Holloway. On their way out of London, then Dick sat down on a stone to rest. It was the 1st of November, All Saints' Day, and the church bells were ringing. As Dick sat and listened, it seemed they were ringing out a message for him. So what was that message? Turn again, Whittington, thou worthy citizen, Lord Mayor of London. So with that ringing bell, he listened this message for him. Lord Mayor of London, said Dick, I should like to be Lord Mayor and ride in a fine coach. I can put up with a few scolding from the cook if that is what is in the store for me. So he decided, let us tolerate cook for some days because my future is very bright. So Dick and his cat retraced their steps to Mr. Fitzwarren's house. Luckily, they were able to slip back before they had been missed. Means anybody could recognize from their family that these two, means Dick is missing, before that they arrived there at their home. Now, Mr. Fitzwarren used to send ships far across the sea to trade with other countries. He would load a ship with goods for the captain and ship's crew to sell in faraway places, and then they would bring back goods that could be sold at home. So Mr. Fitzwarren was dealing with the business of selling and purchasing of goods. So whatever goods from his country, he used to purchase it and he used to sell it to the other countries, and in other countries whichever things are good, he used to purchase it from that country and sell out in his country. So he was a good merchant and he was dealing with the goods. One day he called his household together. So one day those who were present at his house, he called all them together. I am sending a ship to the Africa coast to trade, he said. Would any of you like to send something of yours on it? You can then share in the profits if the voyage is successful. So what he said that if anybody want to give any goods to sold out at that place can give. If this voyage is successful, definitely he will give share to that person. After selling their goods, whatever money will come, it will be given to the people. Everyone produced something except for Dick, because Dick was having nothing, who had nothing to offer. Have you nothing of your own, Dick? Asked Mr. Fitzwarren kindly. And Dick replied, only my cat. Then let your cat go on the ship, said Mr. Fitzwarren. His daughter, Alice, said, Dick loves his cat. Let me put something in for him. But her father said, no, it must be his, not something belonging to someone else. As it is the matter of trading, nobody can give anything on behalf of Dick. If Dick want to give anything of his own, he can give it. So Dick fetched his cat and said goodbye to it sadly. The captain of the ship was delighted, for the cat was an excellent mouser. Excellent mouser means what? A animal that catches mice. She was very good at that work. And so he had no trouble with rats and mice on his voyage. After some months, the ship arrived at a place on the African coast, Barbary, where people called the Moors. Moors lived. Moors lived means a boundary people lives. The means it was considered as a boundary, and a means from that place, no one was going anywhere for voyage. The captain sent a message to the king to say he had fine goods for sale and he was invited to the palace to show them. While he was talking to the king and queen, some dishes of food were brought in. But almost immediately rats and mice ran up and before the captain's eye ate all food. The captain was astonished and asked if this was what normally happened. That means captain was very surprised that this is the palace of king, and here king rats and mice are not under the control of king also. King is unable to solve this problem. So he asked them, is it a normal way? So king replied, alas, yes. Very sadly he said, yes, came the reply. The country is suffering from a plague of rats and mice and we cannot get rid of them. I think I may have the answer on my ship, said the captain. And he sent a message asking for Dick's cat to be brought to the palace. More food was laid out and the rats and mice appeared as before. The cat immediately killed at least a dozen before they scattered. Everyone was delighted and the queen asked, what do you call this animal? Puss is the name, she answers to, said the captain. And when the queen called Puss, Puss, the cat went over to her and purred. The queen was a little alarmed at first. That means she was little afraid of the cat, because first time she was looking this type of animal and she don't know she is going to attack or what. As she had seen how fiercely the cat had attacked the rats and mice. But the captain told her not to be anxious. That means not to worried. That she is angry when she saw rats and mice only. Puss is very friendly with people, he said, and would soon rid your kingdom of rats and mice. I would give great wealth to own this animal, said the queen. So queen was ready to purchase cat at any cost. So the captain began bargaining and it was agreed that the king would buy the whole cargo from Mr. Fitzwarren's ship to pay a fine price for it, and for the cat alone, the king paid 10 times the sum again. That means whatever he paid for the ship, cargo, 10 times of that he was ready to pay for cat. When the ship came back to the port of London, the captain showed Mr. Fitzwarren the gold and jewels he had brought from Barbary and told him the story of the cat. The merchant sent for Dick. "From now on, Dick," he said, "we should all call you Mr. Whittington, for you are a rich man." So now Dick became a rich man, and that's why Mr. Fitzwarren decided not to call him Dick, but now onwards everybody will call him Mr. Whittington. Mr. Fitzwarren then paid him all the money the captain had received for the cat. From this time on, Dick worked with Mr. Fitzwarren and became a successful merchant himself. He married Mr. Fitzwarren's daughter, Alice, and 3 times he was elected Lord Mayor of London. He was also in time knighted by the king, and that means honored with this title by the king, and becomes Sir Richard Whittington. He was not only famous, but he was popular too, for he always helped the poor with his money. Sometimes when he was old, he would tell his grandchildren the story of his cat and how the bells of London had called him back when he was only a poor boy. Means how the bells of London called him back when he was poor. "Turn again, Whittington, thou worthy citizen, Lord Mayor of London." And that is all about Mr. Whittington's life. And because of his cat, he became a rich person of the London. Okay. So that is about the story of cat and Dick. So for question and answers of this lesson, please watch my next video, and I hope that everybody might have understood this explanation. If you have any problem, you can write down in comment box. Please subscribe my channel and don't forget to click on bell icon. Thank you.